Hey, y'all. Well, I just thought I'd give you a little update. I just got through eating at Taco Bell. I've kind of gotten hooked on their nacho Bel Grandes. Now, let me tell you, I went through the drive-thru, and when I was ordering, I told the young man, I said, you guys make the best nachos. They are so good. I also get a senior Pepsi, so my Pepsi is free. I'm telling y'all, this young man gave me 2 orders of nachos in one. I am fuller than a tick on a bloodhound, let me tell you. I am so full, but it was delicious. I just have a thing about crunchy chips and, you know, all that stuff. But anyway, I just wanted to tell y'all that I don't think you can see through his filthy windshield. I had to leave the Taco Bell parking lot because I didn't want to make this video because there was a gentleman sitting underneath a palm tree that was right on the other side of the fence. And I could see he was sitting on a box and he had a backpack and I couldn't see his face or anything, but I could see that every once in a while he was lifting up a bottle in a brown paper bag. Whenever I see somebody like that, I always feel like that God has given me an opportunity to share what I have. And so I got up my nerve and walked over and I said, sir, I said, are you by any chance, are you hungry? Could I buy you something to eat? And he just got the biggest smile on his face and he said, oh yes, ma'am, that would be awesome. So I took his order and I went in to Taco Bell and the young guy at the drive-thru looked at me like he was so surprised to see me coming in to get more food. And so I put in an order with a little extra for the gentleman. And I went outside and I gave it to him. And he was asking me about Washington. He said he had lived up there for 30 years. And we had a little chat. And I just told him, I said, well, enjoy your lunch, okay? And what a good feeling, y'all, just to... Even though he was smoking cigarettes and he was drinking something out of a bottle, I imagine it was a beer. But I'm always, always happy to share food with somebody. And I know how addicting alcohol and cigarettes. My parents were alcoholics and they smoked 2 packs of cigarettes each every day. So I get that. It's horrible addictions, but you still get hungry and you still need food. Anyway, that was just a little story. It just happened to me, you know, off the cuff. I just happened to park and eat and see that gentleman sitting on the other side of the trees. But as far as Tank goes, I took him to a new mechanic. They looked him over. And come to find out what was wrong with him is the guy at Geary's that worked on Tank adjusted his timing and he did it incorrectly. Tank is running like a champ now. It is so awesome, you guys, to just be able to turn the key and crank him up, and his 8 cylinders are just nice and loud and strong. And so I am so thankful and I'm so blessed that he's running again. Anyway, he's got to have shocks. Those are about $500. He has to have brakes. That's about $250. So we're just going to try and do what we can as we can so I can be prepared to go to the winter RTR. And I'm so looking forward to that. But I hope you guys are doing good. You know, I don't get to watch videos this much because when I'm with my girlfriend or in her apartment with her, she can't stand to hear me listening to videos. So I have to do it when we're not together. Her brother is here this week from Washington, and he's been taking her to her doctor's appointments and visiting with his mom. And they've been doing some things with my girlfriend's daughter, Emma. And so I've kind of had a couple of slack days. So I'm trying to get all the laundry caught up and do just a little bit of housework and stuff and hang out. But so I've had some very much needed time alone. I get on overload, y'all, when I have to be around people all the time. It just drives me nuts. I love to sit in tank and just read or, you know, whatever. But anyway, this is getting kind of long. This is over 6 minutes. That's long for me. But my girlfriend does have a place on the side of their, they own a duplex, and it's an upstairs that they live in, and then the downstairs they rent out. And I've lived on that street ever since I've been here and have had no problems. But I tell you why I haven't. It's because people see me going in and out of her apartment. So I'm not a stranger, you know, parked on the street that nobody knows or anything like that. So I've been very, very fortunate, except for my street sweeping ticket. And I made sure this past Monday, Tank was not sitting there. He was in the shop. But she has a side yard that's got a big privacy fence around it. And I think that Tank is, that's going to be his new home for a while. And they've got a gate that's about 10 feet wide. So I'm hoping I'll be able to drive him in there and then I'll be off the street. I'll have a little bit more privacy. It'll be a little bit quieter. Because when you're four blocks from the ocean, let me tell you, there's a lot of people. A lot of people. Skateboards, people with their dogs. I mean, it's just a great little neighborhood, but it is kind of noisy. I managed to sleep though. But anyway, I just love you guys. And I, when my girlfriend's brother leaves, then she and I are going to get out and make a couple of videos around Oceanside. But y'all take care and be safe and be sure to do something fun. And a special hi to Irene and Mango, of course. And also Lynn Pinto. I haven't heard from you. I'm a little bit concerned. I hope you're all right. Anyway, talk to y'all later. Bye.